All right, leaving Sachs Bridge. Another haunted location. Beyond the previous video that's talking about it, I just realized there's a dam back behind it. All the years I've come here, I never realized the bridge was just before the dam. Amazing the things you just don't realize. Busy focusing on a haunted bridge, not paying attention to other stuff. So I'm going to go back up into the battlefield. There's all kinds of great stories about Sachs. You can look them up. I won't go into what I did on a previous video, but they get a lot of activity there, all kinds of voices. They see soldiers on the bridge, orbs, things like that. And I heard stories about soldiers being tied to the base of the bridge so they wouldn't blow the bridge up. And the bridge as it stands now has got concrete pillars on both ends, so I assume it had to have wood actually driven into the river at some point. Which it's not there now, so otherwise I don't know how to exactly we're tying people to the bridge. Unless it was just tied up on the upper parts, who knows. I heard stories about drowning and bodies floating by and all that sort of stuff. But I would do your due diligence and look all that up. I didn't before I came here. I wasn't even planning on going to the bridge. I'm just hitting other routes. So this way tonight, when I get out, I can get to the battlefield, do another night of investigating, which I'm going to go out a little bit earlier because it got dark real quick. And I'll bring proper lighting with me. Hopefully set up someplace. Plus last night, I'm not sure how windy it's gonna be tonight. Last night it was very windy, which makes doing EVPs kind of tough. I'm using just a phone for my recording, my iPhone, which does a decent job, but it's not exactly, it's not exactly night vision. I do have a couple of GoPros I brought and some other stuff, but I'm trying to keep it as simple as possible. I have tons of equipment, and I am going to do an investigation in the hotel room. It's my last night there. Everything's already set up, so I just got to do it. Now, you got to remember, Gettysburg, everything in town is a battlefield. Literally, there's what they call the battlefield, which is the grassy areas with all the monuments. But, Jenny Wade was shot. A lot of other people were shot right downtown on Baltimore Street. So, there's no reason I shouldn't be able to get activity. The hotel room, which I have, is right downtown, so if I can summon something up out in the field, I should be just as easily to get something, some activity there, where there's actually more human presence. Like I said, I'm going to try to get out a little bit earlier. Yesterday was kind of a mess. I was waiting for 6:30 to do a Zoom conference call for the town commissioner, town of Littleton. But it got canceled on Confederate Avenue here, as you can see I'm turning. It's one of the few towers that are left. Being canceled was fine, but it just kind of put me on hold. Otherwise, when I got here, I could have went right out and started doing some exploring instead of worrying about making sure I was logged into the internet and all the rest, I'm going to try to get back to Jenny Wade House. Do that too tonight. Like I said, it was very, very crowded last night. There was a tour that went in. I was waiting for them to get out. Then there's groups of people were coming up. It's kind of hard to sit there with a recorder and some meters and do EVPs without having a lot of people looking at you like you've got some kind of mental disorder. But I will hell or high water get something done there today. I'm just taking some of these back roads through. I haven't been on in a while, years. I'm just trying to familiarize myself some of the spots I want to get into. Hopefully areas where there's not a lot of people. I can actually set up some equipment and literally get some decent investigating done. Don't mind me, I'm looking around trying to familiarize myself with these little side roads and monuments off to the side, see if where I want to go. There's the Arkansas Monument. Okay, now we're back crossing the main road. This is actually the road I was looking for on the other side, which should bring me right into Little Round Top and that sort of stuff. I gotta do this without killing somebody here. Got a truck coming and a bunch of guys on bicycles. Looking good. The Eisenhower thing I've never done either. That's another place I could definitely check out. These guys are wide berth. Yeah, I think there's a little round top right over to my left over there. Bicycles out. Actually, it might be a cool way to come here one day with bikes. Park somewhere, roll in, you can get into spots where a lot of the cars can't get. Quiet way to get into an investigation. Actually, I saw a group of bicycles before. There was a woman leading them on a bike, and they pulled up and stopped, and she was actually doing a bike ghost hunt, basically riding around, and she was talking about the different events, which I thought was pretty cool. That's unique. Thinking outside the box. Yep, yeah, got some cars. I think I'm in the right area now. I think I would just spring for a map and know exactly where I'm going. Since I'm using my phone for the camera, I can't use as a map, but I should recognize the road now since I was here last night coming in the other direction and managed to take every direction I turned was the one-way road going. I was heading the wrong way, so. Yep, that looks like it over there, but wouldn't be the first time I've been wrong. One thing I want to make sure I do today is eat. I haven't eaten today. I'm bad about that when I get on the road. I just don't eat. I don't hydrate enough. I think that's why I was feeling lightheaded coming out here. I can hear a cavalry thing in there. That's pretty cool. I thought there'd be a road turning up in here towards the high ground, but I don't see it yet. Makes me kind of wonder if I'm not where I think I am. Going around here. I am coming in a totally different direction than I did yesterday. A lot of trails in here. It's a trail I've never taken. This is, I think, exactly where I was trying to get yesterday. This could be fun. If I can do this, once again, me trying to transfer you from this to a selfie stick without losing you. I always tend to lose. Push some button. Go. Got the selfie stick. So far successful. Okay, this should be the path takes us down to Devil's Den. Hello, hello.
Hi, how are you?
Good. That's the area up there. It's Hell's Kitchen. I can't, on the way back up, I'll get up there. Boy, this is, they put a lot of new rocks in here. Not the easiest walking. And there are battles all up and through here. This is a hotbed shooting down. I would imagine the trees weren't quite as thick back then, but who knows? This was, I'm sure, soldier to soldier fighting in this area. This is a little round top. It's off to this side here, where I was last night, but by the time I got up there, it got dark real quick, and that video's a little rough to see. Like I said, it was windy trying to do EVPs. I'd like to come back tonight into this area, because this hopefully is a little quieter, being in the woods. Less people. Look at the size of these rocks around here. It's crazy. Yep, this is the path. And you can see this is not one of the trails. See all the rock formations up there? That's where I came with my family when the kids are small. My daughter Heather wouldn't even get out of the car. She was so scared. You can climb up on those. There's a trail that goes up in there. Apparently they were firing from that position down here. And then there are people behind, obviously, rocks the size of these things. You can see me next to it. These things are huge. But once we get down here, actually, I should be able to take that trail back up. You can see we're going to come out. You can already start to see it through the trees. Devil's Den, where a lot of the famous photos of the soldier that was moved. They actually posed them, some of the first fake news. A more dramatic shot where he was set up with a sniper rifle. But this is a very popular place. And then you've got a triangular field out behind on the other side. I want to get into more of these little back things here. It's going to take me spending more time down here. Hopefully once we get... So we're hoping with the museum, when life comes back to tourism, we'll be at a spring for a basic camper of some sort. So save me money on hotels, be able to come down and actually spend a week with a couple of people and really cover some territory. Now, there's no camping, obviously, in the park, but you can. Our campsite's pretty close. Now, you can see where we're coming out. A little bit of a hike. Is that gorgeous? Now that's where these volleys are going. Now this is a little bit raised, but they're obviously, we came from, was much higher. And little round top is up to the other side. Let me step down a little bit more, show you. So when you have elevated position, obviously that's a large advantage. We can see we're still going down. So they're hiding amongst these rocks here. And up there is a little round top. The only way to deal with something like that, obviously, is to try to get from behind them, which they tried and it didn't work. So I'm not going to walk down there because I'm going to drive there later. I'm going to go back up and show you Devil's Kitchen. Get my cardio for the day here. Walking these inclines. still pretty windy today, so we might have problems with EVPs. But even on this walking, we might pick up something on the audio. You never know. Hello, hello. A little bit of sun coming through the trees in my eyes. Never seen it so busy on this trail. Usually it's like nobody uses this one. Starting to huff and puff. You can see the boulders throughout here. When you're in a battle, this would be the ideal spot. And these things are huge. Now the spot I'm going up to, I haven't been to in probably close to 20 years. At least 15, 16. And if I remember correctly, there's huge crevices you could fall into. I thought I was seeing fossils there. You see how rocky this is? You gotta be careful through here. That's why at night, look at this. Look at this terrain. At night, this can be very treacherous. Last thing you do is want to snap or sprain an ankle up here. There's another trail that goes off that way. See how rocky this is? This is what I'm talking about. Look at some of these crevices here. I mean, this is huge. This is all natural. Let me step up in there to show you. See? Gotta be at least 10 foot deep in there. Anybody in here that wants to talk to us? Can you give us a name? Can you tell us what year it is? Here, just a shot in the dark. Since I'm here. If you could camp, this would be the place to do it. Even look here, look at these gaps in here, places you could fall. You can see how it drops off. It's impressive, isn't it?
I'm going to wander back now to the car. And before I do that, I'm going to log off, say thank you for watching again, supporting us. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll get some pictures of this stuff to post along with it. Talk to you soon. A lot of investigations going on tonight.